Here's Ritter now to throw on their first play. And complete to Drake London. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Flag comes in, this might be a free play. Airing it out deep for Smith. And that'll be incomplete. The flag was down, so they took a shot. Thinking it's on the defense, let's see. Now they'll try to take advantage of that offsides call. Here's first and 5. Back to throw, Ritter. And a dump off here to Robinson. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. Another throw coming up here for Ritter. That's to the right sideline, and it falls incomplete.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he let him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground incomplete.
An incomplete pass on second down. That muddles things a little bit here. This is 3rd and 10. Out of the gun, here's Ritter. The ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Got the opening possession they were looking for, especially on the road.
No doubt about it, because they wanted to come out and establish a little momentum right away. But now bringing up a 4th down, an empty possession, not what they were seeking.
Ritter on the 4th down try. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert. And they turn it over. A surprising move here on the opening drive of the game. And on the opening drive of the afternoon, the defense forces a turnover on downs. Defensively by the Falcons. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this 1st quarter. And 10, it's Swift. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. Give him 3 on 1st down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. Hurts. He's going to look deep for Watkins. And this is caught. Touchdown. Chris Watkins, 46 yards. And the Eagles are on the board first here this afternoon. The fly route works for the TD ground.
And you know what the receivers love to say? If we get even with the defender, we're leaving.
No,
and
that's exactly what he did.
All the way into the end zone. And then he was on the business end catching it once he got over the stripe.
Now he's back out there to boom this one away. Maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. Patterson going to bring this out of the end zone. And not a good return here at all as they'll be forced to start at the 12-yard line. begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. Charles, we'll see how this offense responds. Remember the last time they were out, they went for it on fourth down, did not get it, and that led to a touchdown on the other side. So they need a response here.
They certainly do, and I just have a question for you. You think that was a gut feel, or was that analytics that came into play there and decided to go for it on fourth down?
That felt like gut to me. What about you?
Yeah, absolutely, because the way it backfired, where they are in the game, those things, that didn't feel like an analytics call. That certainly felt like, hey,
now it's third and one. Ritter to throw it. Eagle pressure, too much this time. Down he goes. It's a loss of 10 on the sack, and it leads to fourth.
And this is what you've got to do against a quarterback like him. You've got to keep him in the pocket and not let him get to the perimeter, because once he gets outside, that's where he can really hurt you.
Now remember, they were unsuccessful earlier in this first quarter. Going for it on fourth, they're going to try a second time. They're going for this. Here's Ritter. A hit as he throws, and this is going to be incomplete. Scratcher there, and now possession will go over inside the 15-yard line. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Here's a handoff to Swift, and he's going to work this one down to about the 5. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3. They'll stay on the ground with Swift. And he's going to get about 3 yards closer. He's down about the 2. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
They'll try and run for it with Penny. And he maybe makes it back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Penny will take this one in for an Eagles touchdown. And they would not be denied on the ground, powering it in just one play after they got stopped short.
And how about how many tight ends are on the field? Because in today's NFL, we think of the tight end more as a pass catcher. But this group, they tell them you've got to be able to run block to stay on this team. And they committed to it and got it done right there.
This time, the extra point up and good. And the lead now stands at 13. 13-0 is the score after one on EA Sports. Elliott now to kick this one away. From his end zone, here comes Patterson. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. Charles, we know that this offense is aggressive. We saw that last drive. They went for it on fourth down, didn't get it. Then they give up the touchdown. So now you feel like they really need to respond here.
They certainly do, but let's face it. Sometimes when you take that risk, you understand if you fail, a little more onus goes back on your ball club to try and pick themselves back up.
Off the play fake, it's Ritter. They'll roll him out right.
You got to be kidding me.
Oh, it's good. Get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. Ritter on first and 10. And he's got his man on the out route. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Working from the gun, Ritter. Escaping the pressure right. And just not enough on the throw there. Down around his feet and incomplete.
Now their backs up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple of more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
Back to the air on second down. Here's Ritter again. Robinson's got it. And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 25-yard line. Ritter from the gun. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. Now second and 5. Going play action. Ritter. He's got Smith here. That one good for 7 as this long drive continues and the chains move again. Right. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Looking to throw it here, Ritter. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
Oh, they were so close. That close to their first points of the game. Just needed to hang on just a second longer. But he couldn't complete the process of the catch through the jostling from the defender.
Second down throw coming for Ritter. Got his tight end. That's complete. That's Smith. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. Sticking with the passing game. Here's Ritter again. And this is caught for a Falcon touchdown. Bijan Robinson from 8 yards out. And the Falcons have got it back to within a score. Connect on the extra point, and it's now 13-7. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. And able to get this out to the 25. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And not an abundance of time remains on the clock, Charles, but you would think more than enough to try to extend this lead before intermission.
And when you talk about extending the lead, I think you're talking about aiming for the end zone because there is plenty of time for that. The fallback is to get 3. But in your mind, you put 6 on the board right before the half. That's a heck of a dagger and great momentum to carry into the locker room.
Throwing is Hurts. This time for Smith, and it's intercepted. And they'll take over inside the 45 at the 44-yard line. They'll take over the first 10-10 at the 44-yard line. First and 10, it's Patterson. Up front, and he's able to navigate his way down inside the 30. First down now, but that clock rolling. On first down, going back to Patterson. Down to about the 22 here. The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Second down and three. Here's Ritter. Now they go screen. It's complete. And oh, caught up. And this is going to kick out of bounds. Boy, a fortunate bounce or two there. They'll keep possession back inside the 10-yard line. Thankfully for the offense, a fortuitous bounce there on the fumble goes out of bounds because they're down here in the red zone. You don't want to lose one there.
You don't want to lose one, and the best part, because it went out of bounds, they retain possession, still have an opportunity to put points on the board.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Looked like both sides were anticipating a quick throw there, and the defense was ready to jump in and deny it, and they did.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Ritter now. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Give him credit for excellent coverage, tight coverage. They're doing a lot of things that we're talking about in basketball that causes disruptions in the passing game. And as long as that continues, it'll be tough for them to gain any momentum throwing the ball downfield.
Oh, shit.
And they'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Desmond Ritter in the final seconds of the first half. And the Falcons have tied the ball game with a chance to take the lead into the locker room. So now this to get themselves a lead here heading into the break. And this puts them on top by a penny. It's 14-13. So 6 seconds, all that remains of this first half as the kick is away. But no run back here. Fair catch, and this will come out to the 25. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And only 6 seconds on the clock, so time likely for just one play. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Going deep here for Watkins. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And he's in for the touchdown. The final play of the first half. The prayer is answered.
How did they get that done?
They had just given up the lead, and they get it right back.
Yeah, how about that? Answered quickly. Got right back to it, and look. Long drives have their place. We know that. They can wear teams down. But when you hit them with big plays like that, that can really be a shot to them. A big time one.
Yeah, one play, but now your defense is probably saying, man, we could have used a little more rest over here. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. So the Eagles with the lead, and they're going to get this football first as the third quarter gets underway. And the fair catch signal for and taken, so they'll begin this third quarter from their 25-yard line. Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10 at their 25-yard line. And now a timeout defensively by the Falcons. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
No touchdown. 63.
Hurts sets up to throw it. And Seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
It's now second and 10 at the 25-yard line.
Hey, 73.
Here's Hurts to throw. That's caught by the big tight end, Dallas Goedert. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. First target, first catch, and a first down.
Exactly that, truly leading his team right now towards victory.
Three touchdown catches, he's been the headline. Elliott good on the extra point, and it gives his guys a 12-point advantage. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Patterson going to bring this out of the end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons' offense at the line. And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go three and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially, but you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that leads you to bigger errors.
Ritter now on second down. And it falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him defensively, and now it brings up third down. Here's Ritter. Pressure comes and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. Multiple players getting home for the 1 yard sack.
We've watched this a long time and I still don't believe we get it. Third and long. Why are you calling play action?
Because they're not going to bite defensively, right?
No, not at all. I did have a coach explain to me years ago that for some teams, that's how they have to deal with pass protection and their line blocking, but to me it seems silly.
Yeah, well, they're silly, and it leads to a play-action sack. And he's got it to Patterson complete. And he is going to have a Falcons first down as they manage to convert, and that'll keep the drive alive. Ritter. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
Just a second earlier, and they might have had him because they certainly thought they were going to close in and drop him behind the line of scrimmage, but he had just enough time to dodge the pressure, and he ends up getting yardage before being stopped.
From the 43, here's second down and 8. Ritter back to throw. That's out wide here for Robinson. He's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down. To throw, Ritter. Throw left side is complete on the diving effort. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
down, Ritter.
Oh my goodness.
Touchdown, Falcons. Jonnu Smith, 23 yards for the touchdown. And the Falcons are able to get a score back in the final stages of this third quarter. Now Youngway Koo for the extra point. And this is back to a five-point game. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. And he'll elect not to run with it. And a fair catch on the kickoff will move the ball to the 25. Still enjoying the lead here in the third quarter despite their defense giving up that last touchdown. Now they'll see if they can get the equalizer here on this drive. They couldn't ask for much more at this point in the second half. A gorgeous day, one score game, first and 10 here. They'll start on the ground with Smith. And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Second and six, just inside the 30. Second down, here's Hurts. There's the former Falcon star, Julio Jones, with the ground. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. First catch so far for Julio. He's got a first down. Smith. So given 5 yards there on the pitch and catch, and that's going to bring up second down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Second down, here's Jalen Hurts. He throws it on the move, but can't connect as that falls incomplete.
So many times we've seen him try to escape the pocket and do something with his legs, but in this case, the pressure was too intense and he made the wise choice to just get rid of the football and make sure no one was going to get it.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. They've got it first and goal as they search for what could be a game-sealing touchdown. So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. Here's Swift. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the one.
That's a great run right there on first down. Didn't quite get into the end zone, but now you've set yourself up for at least two, maybe three more shots from close range.
Another yard would probably put this thing in the books. It's second and one. Oh, the sneak. It's Hurts. And he is over the line for another rushing touchdown.
Is he a quarterback or is he a tailback?
Jalen Hurts scoring on the sneak from a yard out. And the Eagles get an important score there to extend their lead here in this fourth quarter. Elliott now to add the extra point. Now these have been no picnic for him so far. He's missed two, but this one is good. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Fair catch going to be taken, and this will be moved down to the 25. They'll come up first and 10 here. Ritter wants to throw it. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Give it big credit for his coverage right there, because when he saw the route break deep, he stayed in position to prevent a completion while avoiding any risk of a flag.
Here's second down. Here's Ritter. Midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. Now Ritter. Pass the 20. 5. And he takes this one into the end zone. And all of a sudden, here in the final minute, things get a little bit tighter. So a big play coming for the Falcons as they'll go for two. Ritter. And he's got it for the two-point conversion. So they tack on a pair more here to narrow that deficit a bit further. Time definitely of the essence now. Just under a minute to play, and here we go. Just about put a camper on this one. The risk reward of the onside kick. When you don't get it, the risk comes out to play, and here they gave up great field position.
And that's the key to everything, because you're trying your best to press advantages when you have them, and field position leads you to that type of play calling, and whether you want a blitz or whether you want to throw the ball deep, those types of things, that they do with that type of field position, and then just switch to their opponent.
Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe to get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college and happen in the NFL. The miracle of the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take the knee and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time. Ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up and wins the game.
What year was that?
1978. I think it was in November.
5 points of contact necessary at this stage as they'll run on first down. And a timeout coming in. This will be their final one with 10 seconds remaining. I guess the simple question, why not just take a knee there?
I don't understand either why you would take any sort of a chance. We've seen it happen in the game of football. It doesn't matter whether you've watched high school, college, or the NFL. Some people get a little greedy trying to get that extra running play in, and it can backfire on them.
What a ball game this was. What a struggle this was. Our team getting the lead touchdown, getting the victory.